No, please no. Okay.
Hi, this is Truls.
And Nikolai.
From Set Your Sails, and you're watching Total Rock.
Or of Total Rock, and I'm super excited today. I'm meeting almost my neighbors. Set Your Sails are back with a massive album, was released last week, Bad Blood. Second album, second and a half.
Second. I'd label it as second, yeah.
How are you guys doing? Thank you very much for joining me.
Thanks for having us. We're good. We slept at home, except him, but...
I slept under the bridge, aka in Henrik's home, which is from the bad situation, kind of equal. No, but we're fine. We just came back from Münster yesterday, second leg of the tour, second of four legs, and yeah, we're exhausted, but we're happy.
Yeah, motivated. It's a hometown show. It's a huge show for us, and we're just happy. The pre-sale went, I don't know, crazy, and gonna be a bunch of people here, a lot of family and friends, and it's special for us, and we're very honored. I just spoke to Andre. I was like, take a look at this venue, remember where we started, and now we're here playing a headliner show. That's sick. Yeah.
Well, I'm always happy to see you guys on stage. I remember how sweaty things got at Summer Breeze a few months ago. And tours last year, so 2023 was massive. You took some time off to focus on the album, and now it's finally here, and I love it.
Thanks.
So how is it for you? Because as you already mentioned, I even looked at previous tours and posters. I saw some shows at the Blue Shell, and
right.
How things evolved. That was supposed to be in December at Blue Shell 2021. They got canceled because of Corona, and things got bigger.
Yeah.
I've seen you with And Is Okay and Caliban and so many great stuff. And now the album is out. I feel like the reception is amazing. I really enjoy the album. So does it feel like something is different for you guys? The imposter syndrome is finally out the door?
No, that would probably never disappear. But I even had a nervous breakdown when I got the master's bag, and I was like, oh my God, this is so crappy. This is not gonna work, it's so shit. I literally laid on the ground crying because I was like, oh my God, this is so, I'm not a good singer. I was even like, you can replace me with a good singer and you can re-record it and whatever. So that will never disappear. But yeah, a lot has changed. As you already said, Blue Shell was our first show ever back in 2017, I guess. And they were like 40 to 50 people, something like that. Yeah, it's crazy. I'm very happy that the album thing is done and it's released and we can play shows again. And we have a lot of shows coming up. And yeah, starting today with the... We're not starting, but continuing today in Cologne.
So how are you guys feeling with the reception? More interaction with the fans, more interaction with press, having more time kind of in the public's eye?
Yeah, it's growing and growing just to see like our own shows now. To have that many people in front of the stage is making the imposter syndrome growing too, because you're standing there like playing your crappy bass and you're just like... Someday they will find out that I'm not as good as they maybe think. Yesterday was somebody and he said, yeah, I'm his favorite bass player. And I said, I'm not even my favorite bass player called Nikolai, whatever. What's wrong with you guys? So that's crazy. The reception of the album is wow. Normally I'm not into reading reviews, well, more than Jules, because she's keeping that away from her, but now I just took some of those, like Metal Hammer or stuff like that, and they all like the album. I think that's super strange, because as Jules mentioned, she was like, oh, it's all crappy, we cannot release this, but I think she made more than just a fantastic job with her voice, with the lyrics, now on tour. I think we're seeing somebody walking towards the Senate.
So how does it feel actually to hear all those positive comments, either from yourselves or from fans? As we said, bigger rooms, online interaction, face-to-face interaction. But then you tell me that when you got the master, you thought they're all going to hate it.
Yeah, it's weird. Like, I don't know. When you're writing songs, you're so into the moment. You're like, I was in a full working mode for 3 months. I was like this. Like got up at 7 a.m. and wrote until 1 p.m. and then got to work. And I was so stuck in this writing process that I totally lost view of the songs. I was like, this is shitty. I don't know how to describe it. If you're writing songs and you're questioning everything, like this riff isn't good enough, maybe we could have done the drums differently, maybe the, you know, everything. And especially with my voice and me, I'm always questioning myself with everything I'm doing. I don't like anything. I've never been proud of myself or something like that. And of course, I hear that, you know, I hear people saying that's good. And I do get the reactions from the people after the shows, and I always come to the merch table. But that's like, I don't know, it's not really getting close to me. I'm always thinking, yeah, maybe you just, I don't know, maybe they just got a bad taste in music, or I don't know what it is. But I don't really believe it. You can say whatever you want. It has to come from yourself. I'm happy with the result. I'm always telling myself, something that I've learned in therapy is that this is all that I could have done. Like, that was all that was coming out of me, and this is it, you know. And if it fits, it fits. If not, then not. But this is what I can do. And yeah, but I do like the songs at the end of the day. I'm very happy with the outcome, and I love the design and everything. And yeah, it's a good record.
Well, I'm gonna make you uncomfortable and say that I love it. Okay, I agree. It sounds great, and I cannot wait to hear it on stage. Can we talk about maybe the difference between the two albums? I know that Nicola and Henrik joined the band between the two albums. Yeah. Do you feel like you guys as a band are different? You guys as people outside of the band are different since Nightfall?
We're looking better.
I love the agreement here. Okay?
Just Henrik is standing over there, and I has to say, Henrik, say hi to the camera.
Look at this.
Hello. I mean, look at this beautiful bum. So we couldn't, we can't be sexier on stage now. But I think the question is more related
but
to
even
you.
On the production side, you feel like something became easier, became more. I know that you talked about getting a bit more personal, a bit more raw, exposing more with the lyrics. But working as a band, you feel like things got easier, more complicated, more professional. Any words that you want to describe the difference between the two albums or the band between the two albums?
Yeah, the band as a whole definitely became more professional. That's been one of the reasons why we parted ways with the boys, because with the previous boys, because they couldn't really keep up with the level we were going to. So we really had an upgrade, you could say it like that. For instance, Henna is a fucking beast on the drums. He's like, he's totally, I don't know, he's like, oh my god, we have to do it like this, we have to do it like that, and then he's totally in his game, and that's...
You can call it the nerd.
He's a real nerd, yeah, and I love that. People are so addicted to things and into their things, and yeah, it's an upgrade, definitely. He looks, I mean, he plays bass, yeah, but he looks pretty good on stage. I'm just kidding. He looks pretty sexy on stage, and that has the whole vibe of the band, even the clothes changed a little. We all grew up a little bit more and pushed it into a cooler look. I don't know. We kind of like look different, behave different. I even move different on stage, and somehow the image of the band shifted a little bit, and everyone grew into it, even Andre. I remember him walking on stage with his bath shoes on, I don't know, flip-flops, what he was wearing. And now it looks as a whole, like the band looks as a whole, and the stage appearance, of course, also changed as a whole, and the whole production is completely different. We have a light guy, we have a sound guy, we have whole production going on, we have stage hands. I don't know, it's a whole crew.
I heard something about pyro.
Pyro, yeah, we do have pyro, like once in a while, not everywhere, of course, because probably we would burn the entire thing down, so, but especially on festivals or something like that, if you want to impress people and stuff and just want to have fun. For instance, Summer Breeze, we were shooting everything. We had like fire jets coming out and we were like freaking out and all that, and that was pretty fun. Yeah, everything became more professional, definitely, yeah.
So it's not a metalcore show as you probably think about a metalcore show. So we want to make a rock show, you know, we want to, I mean, Jules was growing up listening to AC/DC, which you both will see this summer.
Yeah,
yes,
finally.
And
yeah,
that's really life goal achievement. We all grew up with, you know, like the old legends, Guns N' Roses, AC/DC, all that stuff. We saw stadium rock shows, of course we're not even a bit of that size, so don't get me wrong. But we want to have that atmosphere that you're at a rock show, not at a big thing. We want to have the coolness. We want to have the sexiness, as you mentioned. We want to have the full thing. And I think we're getting from show to show, from tour to tour, we're getting closer to what we like to see as fans, probably. And yeah, we just want to give the people what we would like to see, and yeah, if they don't like it, it's their problem.
Well, I enjoyed it, and I cannot wait to see it even getting bigger and bigger. One more thing that I really like about your show is that you're literally holding an inclusivity flag, waving it, calling for people to be kinder to each other. But my question is, do you see the change coming out of the venue into the world? Because I feel like sometimes it's easy to talk to the people that like you, to say, be nicer against racism, against homophobia, against all those negative things. But do you feel like people are brave enough, strong enough to go outside and bring that change to the outside world?
I think we, yeah, I mean, as a society in general, we grew pretty much into it more, definitely. There's more awareness out there. Still, there's a lot of hate. I feel like, and it depends where, who you're talking to, or where, on in which part of the internet you're, you're on social media, and which sites you're visiting and stuff. But I don't know. I feel like there's so much hate out there, and people are so vocal about it. Like they're pointing out everything, but on the other side, there's also so many people standing up against it. And I mean, everyone can do their part, right? So what we can do is being vocal about it, doing our shows and on social media, and hoping that will encourage other people to do the same. And if everyone is doing that in their environment, then we have this as a whole, as a bigger thing. But yeah, of course there's a lot of hate. I mean, we always see that when we're posting new videos or something like that. There's always someone commenting some sexism shit or whatever. You always have that. But standing up, still, like, I mean, we're still here, we're still waving the flag, we're still being vocal about it in public. I'm openly gay, so this is like, I don't know, this is all we can do, you know, and not remaining silent is the best that everyone can do.
Well, I appreciate your honesty about that, and I'm really hopeful that it will be just, whoever wants to join can join. Everybody feels welcome to either rock in the mosh pit or get on stage, pick up an instrument, do whatever they want, regardless of their history or their story.
Sure.
So I love that, and I really appreciate you guys speaking up for that. I want to get a bit more personal and ask about some rumors from the recording studio. The name of the album.
Oh, come on, I know what's coming now.
Yes, I heard that Nikolai had a big part in that. Between the release date, there is just 8 days before is Icon releasing a new album. Is Bad Blood a tribute to Nikolai's favorite person in the world, Taylor Swift?
You know, the fun thing is, like, 5 minutes ago before we sat down, he was like, there's probably going to be Taylor Swift question. So no, it has zero things to do with Taylor Swift.
Did you just pull an Inception? It made you feel like it's your idea.
You know, the thing is, Jules thinks that it has nothing to do with Taylor, with Queen T. But no, I was just, yeah. I mean, Bad Blood was the name of the first single. First single, I mean, Best of Me was there before, but I was really happy that a song was called like this, and then we as a band were talking about the album title, and I think it was pretty fast after you had the lyrics of Bad Blood that it would be a perfect album title. So I was keeping my mouth shut until we fixed it with our label so that the album was like this. I went to André and I said, do you know that Bad Blood is like a very good song by Taylor Swift? He was looking dead eye. You're joking. I was like, yeah. Thank you.
So well but done.
It has nothing to do with Taylor Swift. For them?
I didn't even know that, to be honest. I mean, I like her songs and stuff. I don't, you know, necessarily listen to it, but I didn't remember there's a song called like that. But yeah, my fiance said, hey, you remember Bad Blood? And like, I was like, oh, there's a Taylor Swift song, but you know what, fuck it, there's like a zillion Bad Blood songs out there. You cannot, I mean, every word has been used before, so it was just what I was feeling in the moment, what the entire mood was while writing the record, so it was a perfect fit. And it sounds cool, sounds fresh.
Yeah, and look how happy it makes him.
Yeah.
Happy Swiftie in the band is best what you can get.
Amazing. I want to confront you with one thing that we talked about in the past, mm-hmm. that Shallows, the cover from the previous album, an amazing version, and you've not watched the film. Did that change finally? Did you watch the Lady Gaga film already? Not yet.
I've watched it like a couple years ago, okay. But I don't quite remember it. I just when I think of Lady Gaga, I think of American Horror Story. So this is all I can think of when I think of her being an actress. So I don't really know what the point of the entire movie is, but I guess there's a guy with the guitar, and then there's a girl with the piano, and then they're on stage and singing the song. I guess this is pretty much it. And then they fall in love or something, probably.
I feel like this will continue as a conversation on the tour bus later.
Yeah. Yeah, it's
I don't know.
There's some love and Cinderella story and betrayal.
All right.
Yeah,
and everything the world needs.
Bradley Cooper kills himself in the end.
Really?
Yeah.
I think it got a bit darker than I remember, but we'll check that as well.
Oh, didn't
but
you?
Again, well, not sure. I think you're mixing it up with the Joker.
No, I'm pretty sure. The Joker, Bradley Cooper wasn't the Joker.
Okay, we'll continue. We'll catch up on that later. Let's talk about the future. Are you finally announcing a
becoming
tour?
An actress.
Are you going into cinema as well? Are you going to make it to the UK finally? I think we're waiting for you guys. Can we talk about that? Is there going to be a wider European tour?
Okay.
We cannot talk about this.
But
right
all
now.
I can say
but
is
we will talk about it pretty soon.
Yeah.
After the tour ends.
There's six letters.
What?
And they're quite named Summer. Wait for it.
What?
SUMMER.
All right.
There's news in summer, maybe.
There's okay. news maybe in summer.
Okay, that was a very, very specific hint. We'll get back to that. Guys, I love the album. Cannot wait to see you on stage. Anything else you want to say to fans out there before we say goodbye?
Thanks for coming to our shows. We are overwhelmed by the entire tour. It's the first co-headliner tour, and we're selling tickets like crazy. It's insane. We are totally overwhelmed. Thanks to everyone who's supporting smaller bands, because you are the reason why we can take the next step, and every other band can take the next step. Listen to our new album, Bad Blood. It's out everywhere. buy our merch. You can support us. See you on tour. There will be more dates released soon.
Yeah.
And listen. Go watch Born Stars Born.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And listen to Total Rock. But the thing is, listen to Total Rock.
Listen to Total Rock.
But the thing is, we really don't take it for granted that so many people are coming to our shows. And if you want to be the special one coming to our shows, I have an extra secret tip for you. Bring André some chocolate. He will love you.
Donuts.
You heard it right here. Don't forget to feed your musicians. Guys, set your sails, Jules and Nikolai. It's been a pleasure talking to you. Cannot wait to see you on stage. And Bad Blood is amazing. So thank you very much for everything.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you all.